Indian Stories. Narration, Katie Haigh. The Alligator and the Jackal. A hungry jackal once went down to the riverside in search of little crabs, bits of fish, and whatever else he could find for his dinner. Now it chanced that in this river there lived a great big alligator, who, being also very hungry, would have been extremely glad to eat the jackal. The jackal ran up and down, here and there, but for a long time could find nothing to eat. At last, close to where the alligator was lying among some tall bulrushes under the clear, shallow water, he saw a little crab sidling along as fast as his legs would carry him. The jackal was so hungry that when he saw this, he poked his paw into the water to try to catch the crab, when snap! The old alligator caught hold of him. "Oh, dear," thought the jackal to himself. "Oh, what can I do? This great big alligator has caught my paw in his mouth, and in another minute he will drag me down by it under the water and kill me. My only chance is to make him think he has made a mistake." So he called out in a cheerful voice, clever alligator, to catch hold of a bulrush root instead of my paw. I hope you find it very tender." The alligator, who was so buried among the bulrushes that he could hardly see, thought, on hearing this, "Dear me, how tiresome! I fancied I had caught hold of the jackal's paw, but there he is calling out in a cheerful voice. I suppose I must have seized a bulrush root instead, as he says." And he let the jackal go. The jackal ran away as fast as he could, crying, "Oh, wise alligator, so you let me go again." Then the alligator was very much vexed, but the jackal had run away too far to be caught. Next day, the jackal returned to the riverside to get his dinner as before, but because he was very much afraid of the alligator, he called out,
"Whenever I go to look for my dinner, I see the nice little crabs peeping up through the mud. Then I catch them and eat them. I wish I could see one now."
The alligator, who was buried in the mud at the bottom of the river, heard every word. So he popped the little point of his snout above, thinking, "If I do but just show the tip of my nose, the jackal will take me for a crab and put in his paw to catch me, and as soon as ever he does, I'll gobble him up." But no sooner did the jackal see the little tip of the alligator's nose than he called out, "Ha ha, my friend, there you are. No dinner for me in this part of the river, then, I think." And so saying, he ran farther on and fished for his dinner a long way from that place. The alligator was very angry at missing his prey a second time and determined not to let him escape again. So, on the following day, when his little tormentor returned to the waterside, the alligator hid himself close to the bank in order to catch him if he could. Now the jackal was rather afraid of going near the river, for he thought,
"Perhaps the alligator will catch me today."
But yet, being hungry, he did not wish to go without his dinner. So to make all as safe as he could, he cried,
"Where are all the little crabs gone? There is not one here, and I am so hungry. And generally, even when they are under water, one can see them going bubble, 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 and all the little bubbles go pop, pop, pop."
On hearing this, the alligator, who was buried in the mud under the riverbank, thought, "I will pretend to be a little crab." And he began to blow puff, 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 bubble, bubble, bubble. And all the great bubbles rushed to the surface of the river and burst there, and the waters eddied round and round like a whirlpool. And there was such a commotion when the huge monster began to blow bubbles in this way, that the jackal saw very well who must be there, and he ran away as fast as he could, saying,
"Thank you, alligator, thank you, thank you. Indeed, I would not have come here had I known you were so close."
This enraged the alligator extremely. It made him quite cross to think of being so often deceived by a little jackal, and he said to himself, "I will be taken in no more. Next time I will be very cunning." So for a long time, he waited and waited for the jackal to return to the riverside. But the jackal did not come, for he had thought to himself,
"If matters go on in this way, I shall..."
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.